Hello, my name is Rakesh Sethi. I'm working as Corporate Executive Chef for Radisson Hotel Group South Asia. Today, I'm here to take you through the module on personal hygiene. Through this module, you are going to learn about basic grooming standards, personal hygiene before entering food premises and while handling food, importance of hand washing and the right way to do it, importance of health of staff, and lastly, visitors policy. So what is personal hygiene? Personal hygiene basically means cleanliness, maintenance of health, and good habits to prevent spreading of disease-causing organisms. As we are aware that microorganisms live in and on the human body, and we as humans pose the greatest threat to the safety of food. Therefore, it becomes utmost important to maintain personal hygiene and ensure food safety. To explain it better, let me begin with grooming first. The food handlers should ensure that they bath regularly. Food handlers should avoid keeping long hair. For female food handlers, the hair must be tied and tucked inside the hair net neatly. As for the male food handlers, the maximum length of the hair should be till mid-ear, and during food production activities, the hair must be covered with the headgear or a hair net. Hands must always be kept clean. Nails should be kept trimmed, and use of nail polish, enamel should be avoided. Food business operators should have a jewelry policy in place. Food handlers should avoid wearing jewelry during food handling. Any jewelry which comes in contact with food must not be worn during food production, as they may pose threat to the food. Before entering food preparation premises, remove rings, earrings, necklace, bangles, wristwatch, and any religious thread. You must be wondering why I am saying that we should avoid jewelry. Let me tell you why. For example, if a food handler is wearing a ring which carries stones, and if a small piece of stone falls into the food, it poses a threat to the health of the consumer. Also, food particles may get stuck in the jewelry pieces and may become a breeding ground for microbes. All food handlers must wear clean uniform while on duty. Now, coming to behavioral and personal cleanliness, here are some important tips which you have to check every day before entering food premises, which makes you a smart chef. Change your clothes and wear the uniform. Other belongings such as mobile phone, money ATM cards, any jewelry like chain or bracelet or rings, wristwatch, pen, etc. should be kept away from food production area. Wash hands and feet with soap and water and dry them using cloth towel or disposable paper. Wear footwears which are made of cleanable material and are only meant to be worn inside the food preparation area. And after wearing them, don't forget to wash and disinfect your hands. It is important to cover your head with effective hair restraints such as headgear, and make sure that entire hair is tucked inside it. Before beginning with food preparation, cover your hands with gloves. Also, if there are any open wounds, cover them with a band-aid or get a dressing done on it. Maintaining personal hygiene during food preparation is a must. There are certain habits which should be avoided while handling food, such as scratching any part of body like nose, back, beard, rubbing of eyes, ears, mouth, running of hand in the hair, chewing of pan masala and gum, smoking inside the food preparation area, spitting in the food premises. If any of them is unavoidable, then wash your hands effectively before resuming your work. A food handler should not taste the food with a ladle. For food tasting purposes, take a small quantity of food in a separate bowl or else in a spoon to be used for one-time tasting. The hands of food handlers can be vectors in spread of foodborne diseases, as the microorganisms cannot be seen by naked eyes. Therefore, it becomes important to wash your hands properly. Let's understand the steps of hand washing. The first step is to wet the hands, then take appropriate amount of soap and start rubbing and scrubbing on your palm, between the fingers, back of the hands, base of the thumb, back of the fingers, fingernails and wrist. Now wash your hands and pat it dry. The hand washing procedure should last for about 20 to 30 seconds. Only use the hand washing facilities as provided by the employer. Sinks which are used to prepare food or wash dishes must not be used for hand washing. hand washing facilities must have warm running water, soap and single-use paper towels or other means of effectively drying hands. Now that you know how to wash hands, the next important topic to learn is when to wash hands. So, hands must be washed after using the toilet, urinal or anytime you visit the restroom. Before and after handling poultry material, before serving food, after cleaning or washing off dishes and tables, before putting the gloves and taking them off, after smoking or chewing off pan masala or a chewing gum, after eating and drinking, after touching any part of the body such as face, back, etc. For healthy food, you need healthy environment and healthy staff. To appoint healthy staff, here are some basic tips you should keep in mind. During the recruitment of the staff, especially the food handlers or other employees, a detailed medical checkup is to be conducted by a professional medical practitioner to rule out any underlying disease. Medical checkup should be conducted at least once in 12 months. The vaccination against entire group of disease shall be decided according to the list as declared by the municipal corporation of that area. Any food handler suffering from illness must be reported to the manager. Food handlers suffering from illness such as that of nose, throat, skin, stomach, bowel or any infected wound must be excluded from the food handling until they have fully recovered. A regular checkup on the employees in terms of personal hygiene, that is general appearance, uniforms, hands, etc. must be checked discreetly. Food establishments must be equipped with sanitary accommodations, that is WC and urinals along with sanitary bins. It is preferable that there is a separate restroom and refreshment area for the employees. Restrooms and lockers as provided to the employees should be kept clean. Poor personal hygiene frequently contributes to foodborne illness, which indicates that the food handler's knowledge and handling practices needs to be improved. Generally, visitors should be discouraged from entering the food preparation premises. Visitors when entering the food production area should be provided with clean and protective clothing, footwear, hairnet and visitor's pass. Separate lockers should be provided to keep their belongings such as bags, wallets, mobile phones, clothes, footwear, jewelry, wristwatch, etc. etc. They should be instructed to wash their hands and not to touch any food item or any food contact surfaces. So here's a quick recap of what we learned today. As a food handler, one may harbor disease-causing organisms on the skin and other parts of the body. Thus, personal hygiene becomes very important in saving food from any kind of harm or contamination. Strict hygiene should always be followed by all food handlers and employees working in the establishment. The employer must keep a check that all employees are adhering to cleanliness and personal hygiene. Provisions for basic facilities such as restrooms and lockers should be provided by the employer, and most importantly, basic hand washing facility is available wherever required. Regular medical checkups of the employees should be done, and persons suffering from illness should not be allowed to handle food. It is also important to provide a clean and comfortable work environment and well-balanced meals while on duty, which helps in increasing performance at work. In case of groundwater being used, then a no objection certificate from Central Groundwater Authority is necessary to be submitted. That's all we have for you on personal hygiene. Thank you and have a good day.